Good noon to everybody. I'll be presenting you the third topic, that is Scrum Aspects. We have already worked on the foundation and the Scrum scenarios. Now, this is a summary of all the things that we have studied now up till now, and there are a few more things which have been added in this presentation. So, about Agile Manifesto, this is again a recap of the Agile Manifesto, that is individuals and interactions over processes and tools, working software over comprehensive documentation, customer collaboration over contract negotiation, responding change over following a plan. Now, on the things on the right hand side are indicator of traditional methodologies versus the agile methodology on the left hand side. Now, there is one thing that what about the time aspect? The time is very critical because agile methodologies, they work on time management, they apply time boxing theory, and that's how the sprints are been decided, and the user stories, their complexities, they will determine the time needed to complete a particular sprint. So right people do the right job, that is the key to the success, and just see to it that the members of the development team are dedicated 100%, they have been allocated. We have seen 4 or 5 times that the development team is cross-functional, self-organized. That is, to remember you, there are 3 aspects, DBT, to remember you, the designers, the builders, and the tester. Now, the things which have been indicated on the right-hand side corner, bottommost, is the, you know, Agile principles, right? It is about the Agile Manifesto. That is about the highest priority is to satisfy the customer. Customer satisfaction is being seen, that whether the customer's voice is being understood by the developer. And then simplicity, that is maximizing the value of the work. Maximizing the value of the work. So avoiding rework after the later phases, isn't it? That was the story that was happening with the traditional process models. That is, they were being either incremental or iterative. But time constraining was not being there. So, maximization and the continuous improvement, even though that has been stated, but on the practical grounds, as the importance was being given to the written documents than the verbal communication. So imprecisions were being there, lacuna of understanding what exactly the customer demands are was being present. And this is the significant thing that has been eliminated when you do face-to-face conversation in doing the agile. The next is the product vision. Product vision is the starting point. It is in a single liner, that is a short statement that indicates the goals, objectives, and benefits. So, writing down the product vision requires the experience, and it is just acting like a summary where we go forward for when we require something and why we require something. So, Moore's product vision model you must have visited in the SRS, that is for whom you are developing the product, who will use the product. Name you will be indicating is a category of a product. Now you may indicate the system type here, that is the task list that you can mention over here, that this particular product does these many things. And that is unlike the competitors, because there will be multiple alternatives for the same thing that is being available. So example is being mentioned over here, isn't it, for CRM functionality, and it is a web-based system that provides a certain set of features. Now here you can tabularize the template in a template form. The tabularization can be also done, and you can indicate the things in bulleted points, then writing a complete statement. And who owns the vision? Naturally, product owner. And can vision be updated? It can be updated based on the market, budget and capacity. And therefore, who updates? Naturally, the product owners together with the stakeholder and the team updates the vision. But the final authority to say about the product vision is product owner. Now, that's why the opinion of the product owner has to be respected, because he is the person, he's not a committee, okay, as we have seen, he is the person who will be responsible in working around with everything that relates in communication with the external elements outside the organization. Now, product backlog consists of epics, as to first see epics, and from epics we can have a gentle decomposition into features, then to user stories. So product backlogs, which contains the features, defects, technical work, it is ordered by priority. And product backlog is eventually, as I have stated, that initially it might be consisting of 100 items. So when you are completing it, you must be reaching out to zero. So backlog iceberg, just try to see to it, okay? It is an just-in-time technique, right, in which different levels of highest level priorities are being detailed at the top, isn't it? Just see to it. 1 to 13 points, need 2 to 3 sprints, and then 20 to 40 points in the release, and 100 plus points, then it is the future releases. Okay, so therefore, the recommendation was, while ranking the user stories themselves or allocating it with the Fibonacci series, likewise working around with planning poker for user story estimation, we must be sensible enough to not to cross these limits, isn't it? So if something could be done in a simple way, or something is very obvious and not complicated, then the things must be set below 13. So therefore, the issue is that if something is going beyond 20, then you have to be a little bit cautious that the user story is becoming either complicated or it is becoming complex. So tools that you can use for product backlog, we have seen the matrix earlier on, and then you can have the physical walls, the whiteboard, the index cards, and post notes. You may use Microsoft Excel. You can use the tools, electronic tools, and then you can work around with the correct kind of an estimated user stories. So here one has to be very much careful in ranking down the user stories. So therefore, it should not go beyond the control of the user. So we may follow the Moscow principle. Moscow principle suggests that there could be must have stories, should have stories, could have stories, and won't have stories. And therefore, This is in short form, or you can say abbreviations, that what we can keep and what we can discard. What we can keep and what we can discard. So must have user stories are the indicator of minimal viable product, that is MVP, minimal viable product. So this is about the makeup of the product. Should have may be the indicator of product competitive, making it competitive. Could have, it is about the delight of the customer. And won't have is that the nothing of the stories. Okay, majority of the stories, that is 65%, this is not a small percentile, they should fall into won't have kind of an basket. So we must be very much clear about won't have, right? And possibly we may work around on must have, should have, and could have. Again, if you are eliminating won't have, let us say if we are eliminating won't have, then the weightages could be must have will be capturing almost 60%, and then you can have a 30 and 10 kind of a combination, or you may keep the must have to be 50%, and then you may go around for 30, 20 kind of an equation, or 50, 40 chain. So such kind of an strategies can be adaptable by the product owner. Now, one can work around on multiple projects, right, or multiple products at the same time. It is not the thing that the team has been allocated with a single project. So multiple projects can be allotted, and that is what is the matrix organization in project management. So reaching out next to the acceptance criteria for user stories. User story is a English statement, just as a user, I want to achieve certain goal or desire so that I will be benefited in some way. Just take an example, as a senior support agent, I want to view the emails sent to the customer so I know which communication took place, right? So therefore, in case of setting up the acceptance criteria, when this can be accepted, just have a thought on this, right? Then one can say that the biggest thing that is been required by the senior support agent is the emails sent to the customer. Now, how many emails you want to view? How many emails you want to view? The emails you want to view, isn't it? Could be past 2 emails or 15 emails or 100. So certain kind of a limit you may put up, okay, based on the screen size and how you can show it and how you can club it up. And just see the intention, see to the benefit wing as well. So I know which communication took place. So here subject wise kind of an filtering can be also applied, isn't it? And you can take up the contributory actions, isn't it, for the benefit, right? So therefore, example, only show last 2 emails sent to the customer. When pressing recent email, show example of email sent. So you may set up the acceptance criteria, isn't it? You may indicate the alternatives, that is the ways that have been suggested. You have to understand the limitations, of course. In this current context of emails, you cannot show the entire email catalog right for year 2-3 years, past 2-3 years, right? So you can have a definite time frame wherein you can show this, these user stories have been happening, okay, and this is how this can be accepted, right? So definition of done, which is the foremost important thing, because you must know where to stop. because my definition project is a temporary endeavor. So let it be done by agile or any kind of a traditional methodology. You may work around on the definition on done, that is a checklist of valuable activities which are been required to produce. So which is the thing that has been done, which is the thing that is not been done, and if the code is developed, tested, it is adhering to the design specifications and there are no gaps in between, and you can have the permittable kind of an gentle degradation of the system functionality, then the acceptance criteria would work and it is recommended to stop on that particular user story. So definition of done is a very crucial aspect, okay, because that may be the end of one particular user story, but that will mark the start or beginning of the next level user story. Now velocity and technical depth. About velocity, we have seen earlier on that how much iteration duration that the team needs and what is the performance of the team. It comments about the performance of the team, that is work completed after each sprint. So the product backlog increment, that is PBI, is also an important factor here. It is a low valued kind of an PBI will be by definitely it is easy to manage than managing an 8. Velocity is used for two purposes, okay, that is to our release planning, where we are deciding the size, and it is used to determine the capacity to do the work, that is for the upcoming sprint. That is, from the previous sprint you learn the lessons, okay, and you apply the lessons learned so as you can do the sprints, and later on you can determine that what is exactly been happening. Velocity is also a diagnostic metric that the team can use. Yeah, so going around, how do we calculate the velocity issue? Right now here you can see that feature A, B, C, D, E, F, G, and there are certain kind of features which are been labeled and they are having the sizes. Now I have mentioned the panning poker, in which we are using Fibonacci series ranging from numbers 1 to n, right? Likewise 1, 3, 5, 8, 13, 21, and combination of that. So release 1 will need 10 to 12 sprints to complete. So 200 points, if the total has been coming up, let us say for a moment, if it has been coming up 200 points, this is merely for example, and divide by 20 points per sprint, then the total comes up to be 10 sprints you will be requiring. If there are 200 points and you are trying to address only 17 points per sprint, then you may go around for 12 sprints. So that's why I was been repeatedly saying that be careful while assigning these sizing points, right? This user story estimation points, that is setting them up into 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13. Okay, nowhere you can see that 13 is to be there, isn't it? You can maximally see once in a while the 8 is been coming. So there is of course no question of having a direct 40 over here, right? So if we have user stories of 5 user stories of 40 points, so 5 user stories are been there and you will be requiring them, okay, very high level kind of hand sprints, right? Okay, probably you will do double sprints, okay, to complete 2 user stories, right? So low velocity is 17, high velocity is 20, what we have to look forward is for high velocity. I hope so you have understood this. Again, to repeat, size the features, right? These features and the user stories, right? They are not indifferent, right? You may apply the same for the user stories. Just see to it while writing the points. Okay, over here, be careful. About 10, if it has been going around, be cautious, right? So that you the sprint can be manageable. So excess work for a simple job should not be done, right? So the velocity will be totally dependent on what kind of an Fibonacci number you write in front of the user story. That is what is the importance here, right? So technical depth, just see to it that it is about rewriting, isn't it? About rewriting, okay. It is the metaphor to explain the business team why creating the software fast to get feedback was a good thing, isn't it? So the technical depth, okay, it works around with an unfit or bad design. It works out with the defects, the insufficient test coverage, excessive manual testing, lack of platform in experience, and poor integration and release management. So if the decomposition structure is wrongly been designed, or it is too much abstract design or too much kind of a detailed design, later on we will be having an heavy duty price, okay, for the integration and release management. So just see to it the consequences of the technical debt. We'll consider the diagram, okay, only for the understanding purpose. Consequences: unpredictable tipping points, increased time to delivery, significant number of defects, rising development and support costs, product atrophy, then decreased predictability, underperformance, universal frustration. This is a psychological kind of an impact of not getting the results on the time after doing repeatedly the same kind of a job. Decreased customer satisfaction, which is against the agile principle, okay, what agile would recommend, and what you are actually achieving is then having increased customer satisfaction, you are having decreased customer satisfaction, and you are building the universal frustrations, right? So underperformance again is the development team's aspect. So effects, as we have mentioned, just to have a look at that, what is meant by product atrophy here? As we stop adding new features or fixing defects, so that could rejuvenate our aging product. The product becomes less and less appealing. So probably one day will be there that nobody will use the product, isn't it? Due to there is no newness that has been added, new demands were not been added, the current defects were not been freezed, and then the resultant is that the decreased predictability will happen, and a dissatisfied customer, once in a while gone out of the range of yours, will not be returning back again to you. So the causes of technical debt, just see to it, there is a difference, isn't it, in the amount of work, okay, and versus the time plot, actual velocity rate and what has been recommended, and there is an lag. Where is the missing point? Here it was the missing point. From here onwards, the lag was too much, isn't it? So just a cross-sectional line was been drawn from this particular point. This area is an indicator of the technical depth. Okay, so unreasonable kind of an technical depth is been happening over here. So this may be a result of delayed or prolonged work okay, or unacceptable kind of an, pattern of defects, not fixing them, okay, an additional functionality is causing the rest of the functionalities to be getting damaged, okay. So the next story is now PBI, okay, the PBI concepts to be worked around with the planning poker. Where planning poker we have seen already, okay. So this is just an example. Just see to the cards, right? Planning poker cards, they are been numbered. Likewise, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, 21. Actually, it is 21, right? And then the values are been changing around, right? So the rules are, just have a rules. The product owner selects the PBI, product backlog items, to be estimated and read item to the team, and private selection of this card has been done, and then it has been exposed to all the estimators, and everyone if selects the same card, that will be the estimate, and then unless the misunderstanding and assumptions are being removed out, the step 3, that is, okay, again and again the card is been given, again and again the estimation is been done, re-estimation is been done. So just like in the playing cards, we multiply play that game. So here the voting is been done repeatedly till we reach to the conclusion, right? So now how to call some story as a complex story, right? This table is extremely important. You can note down slide number 14, right, for the same. Card 0, not shown in the figure, okay, but ideally it cannot be the reality. Half we do not use, okay. And 1, 2, 3, used to size the small items. 8, 5, 13, used to medium items, okay. Usually we are using it for medium items. 20 directly incorporated and 40 directly incorporated, okay. So used to size the large item, feature or theme. Now you should not rank it to the user stories now, okay. Just see to it, okay. The sum of all, isn't it? The feature is representing the sum of all, that is the sum of all the user stories, okay. So for features it's okay, 20 and 40, but for user stories, okay, you should not use even 20, okay. So you should halt at 13. So 100, it is an indicator of very large kind of a feature or an epic. Infinity, out of reach, question mark, you haven't understood the product, pi, it doesn't mean 3.14 and so on and so on. Pi card is used when a team member wants to say, I am tired and hungry. I am tired and hungry and I want to get some pee. Some planning poker decks use a coffee cup image. So when you are receiving boredom out of having the planning poker game, then you may like to quit, okay, or you may have to have a break, right, in the usual traditional sense we do. But important points to note, up to 13 we will use it for user stories, 20, 40 for features, reaching out to 100 indicator of epics, okay, because we know the decomposition structure, epics to features to user stories. Now these things we have seen, okay. Product owners faces two directions, right? Which are these two directions? One is the stakeholders, another one is the scrum team, and there is a scrum master, okay, controlling the development team. So that's not that easy for product owner to handle internal stakeholders, external stakeholders like customers and users, and to have with the internal parties likewise, scrum master and his team, right? So grooming of the product backlog is the important thing that the product owner has to do, and review of the each sprint also has to be done by the product owner. So a day in a product owner's life: oversee grooming, participate in sprint planning, answer questions, attend when possible, if not possible send a representative, that is business analyst, right, as we have discussed previously also, perform the sprint retrospective, and with the stakeholder meetings work with the product envisioning, that is product vision creation, perform portfolio planning, then release planning, product planning, and then assign weekly structure, right, to what has been getting achieved, right? So potentially shippable product increment, that is PSI, has to be also constantly monitored along with the PPI, that is product backlog item. Now scrum masters, we have seen in detail with the previous slides also. This is just an revision or recap. Anything new in this thing? Inference shield or interference shield. Interference shield from the external parties. You cannot question directly the development team. Ask me first. That is what is the scrum master tells, isn't it? Yeah, outside of the society, watchman will stop you. Before entering your house, the head of the house should stop the strangers. That is what is the thing is. And impediment removers, that is to handle the defects and all and all. Okay, so scrum master and product owner, scrum master characteristics. One of the biggest thing, okay, above all, is that the scrum master must have patience. Must have patience. You are knowledgeable, okay. You may have questioning ability, you are collaborative, you are protective, you are taking care, isn't it? You are transparent enough, okay. So what a product owner conveys to you, you are reporting, okay, about the development team. But what you should have, okay, is the patience. If team is not performing, then you should have patience, isn't it? You should wait for certain duration, give your development team time. If you won't give them time, isn't it, how they will be coming out of the current context? Because if you are hampering the psychology of the development team, they will not be self-organizing and self-motivated. So that is against the agile principle. So the biggest quality that the scrum master should have is the patience. Next is the relative estimation. We have seen planning poker. Baselining is another alternative, time versus points, and comparing teams, and what is not to be done, that is interesting. Don't allow anyone to shout estimation aloud before the team estimates together, right? So this is the typical mistake that come on, it's not 40, it is a 3. Okay, this is an indicator that you are only knowledgeable, rest are all only the creatures brought from the outside world. That is what is the thing, okay, and where comes the respect here about the team members? It's gone, isn't it? Yeah, and if the development team member makes up the mind, okay, this guy has been saying, okay, always consistently that it is 40, not it is 3, it's not 40, it's 3, it's not 40. Let him alone decide, okay, estimation, why we are required. Isn't it? This kind of a mindset is a dangerous kind of a mindset, and this will restrict the participation. Next thing is the sprint. Isn't it? Time boxing, we all know. Just take a look at, popular sprint lengths, 2, 3, 1, 4 weeks, or 4 weeks could be there as a 1 month, but it should not go beyond 1 month. The don'ts, in don'ts, okay, just see to the important points over here. Have a couple of days gap between the sprints, right? Because you have to retune. Yeah, the gap is been required because the work will become monotonous. And the monotonous kind of an, you know, upbringing will also indicate that there is a kind of an, you know, lag, that we are doing it for, you know, many of the times, isn't it? We are tired enough. Alright, so certain break is essential, certain, you know, gap is also required. Then sprint, okay, the has to be designed in such a way that one must split the testing and other quality checks into another sprint, okay, let it not be combined. It doesn't mean that the testing team, okay, because DBT will be there, so testing team will not sit idle, and people will focus, okay, and till from, okay, Monday to Friday, people are not focused, especially enough on Fridays, because that is the end of the day of the working calendar into the week. So don't give important work, okay, on Fridays especially, because Monday is the beginning, isn't it? That's why many a times Friday is kind of seen as a relaxation day everywhere, right? So sprint goal, realistic and smart. In the second assignment, you use the SMART approach: specific, measurable, achievable, relevant, and timely. And sprint backlog. We are already aware about sprint backlog. You may use the super sticky post notes, which can be sticked onto the walls. Okay, many of the people are been practicing this. Yeah. To do, in progress, and done. So usually the sprint meeting is not been conducted in an, you know, auditorium or in a big kind of an workplace. It has been conducted, okay, inside a small room where 8 to 9 people can be accommodated, and along with product owner, 10 people, right? No 11th person is required there, right? So in small rooms, small discussions for 10 minutes, finish, right? So impediments, defects, etc., etc. And then how to deal with the impediments, search for the impediments, okay? Look at the impediment words, okay? Be careful about these words. Still waiting, not available, hopefully do it, wish that it should be, I guess that, I expected that, I thought that, I have tried, isn't it? So limit the number of impediments, isn't it? Because you may have reasons, isn't it? Up to how much kind of an levels you can have the reasons, practically you have to prove that. So burn down chart and burn up chart. Burn down chart means initially you are having, let us say, 55 user stories. At the end, isn't it, on certain schedule work, the delivery should have been ended here, but still there are 10 user stories that are been remaining. So when they will be over, the burn down chart will be over. So burn down chart is an indicator of work that has been outstanding, and burn up chart that displays the work done. So which one you will like? You should like both the things, isn't it? Product owner and scrum master would see to this particular kind of endeavor, that okay, now 55 remaining, now 49, now 18, just 18 out of 55, 18. One cannot say that, okay, 55 has been achieved, now what about 18, okay, it's a small figure. Yeah, 10 has been achieved, that is the point of delight right here. But concern is there, 10 is remaining as it is, so pressure is there. Now, what is for the development team's delight? from initial is 0, the work is not completed. Okay, just 6, just 23, 37. Yes, at least 50% we have done, but still keep remaining. Okay, 37, 37. Then I jump to 45. Now the last ladder, the lag is there. Okay, 55 and 45, lag of 10. Here also there was lag of 10, isn't it? Yeah. So the burn down charts versus the burn up charts, isn't that? Who has been looking around? That is also important. Right, as I have said that product owner and scrum master, they observe this territory. Burn down, burn up. Okay. What is the work done? Isn't it? Daily stand up, we have discussed why to do it, when we do it, how long. This is the maximum time limit. Okay, 15 minutes is also a very big time. Sprint planning has to be done. Okay, part 1 and part 2. Okay, sprint review. Now, just see to it, that is very interesting. Okay, that's why this presentation has been taken. Say no to a what? Say no to slides. Show working software instead. Because we may show 50 slides and we may not have the implementation. What is the focus of Agile? Is working software. So please don't show the slides when you are there with the Agile. Show the working software. Say no to showing incomplete stories. The story is complete, then only show. Incomplete stories, people will measure you. Okay, first they will measure the user stories, and then they will be measuring incomplete stories and will start asking you the questions. Okay, so before that you should say no, I haven't completed these user stories. Say no to scrum master or product owner doing a demo. Why it is essential? It is better for the development team to demo their own work. Yeah, give me a complete demo. One particular entity, I am the team leader, I am the boss, I am the group head, right? I will do. Okay, you are very good in communication. Okay, you will alone handle the responsibility of communicating. That will not be entertained, right? So prerequisites, just see to it, the complete and incomplete stories catalog, big boardroom with projector screens, and typically 1 hour, okay, has to be needed, okay, to prepare all this. 1 hour is a very small time. Okay, you cannot do too many things. Okay, so too many adjustments are not been possible at the dead end. Okay, that is what is I can tell you. You can manage everything, that's fine. You can make a fool of everybody, but you can't fool yourself. That is what is the outcome of the sprint review. That you must understand in some kind of a different kind of an way. Sprint retrospective, as I have indicated that it is a formal review. So naturally it will be taking up a long duration. The last day of each sprint, that is 28th day of a sprint, 1 to 1.5 hours, that is 1 to 1 hours. That is 1.5 is also not a thing, it has to be mentioned in minutes, 1 hour 30 minutes, right? Who should be present? Mandatory for development team and scrum master, right? Then only the things will be posted, right? So just see to it that what happens is identify the most painful items, isn't it? Thumb over on how retrospective went, not verbally comment, you did it in this way, okay, don't raise your expectation, just thumb vote, isn't it? If the thumb vote is not been coming, you should understand what you have done, isn't it? Yeah, actually, yeah, then the backlog refinement, 30 minutes to 2 hours, increased size, yeah. And you may approach here for invest kind of an story. The good user story is independent, negotiable, valuable, estimable, small, and testable. That is invest approach we will be using for food user story. So user stories are been also refined. Two big user stories are been broken down. Too many complexities are not required. I have told you that seriously you should think that if anything is going beyond 10, because those many number of sprint we will be requiring. Now the scrum master fullest level kind of an responsibilities are being stated. Three important responsibilities are facilitating the scrum events, identifying the impediments, guardian of scrum process, and the thing on the left hand side will tell you the entire list, right? Likewise, continue personal growth in agile, that is user groups, conferences, reading books, articles, writing blogs, isn't it? So consistently one has to not only do the work for the others but doing the work for the self as well, because it has been reckoned that first we should be part and parcel of development team, gain some experience, gain some training on Scrum Master first, have the practicalities resolved, then go forward for the role of product owner. So this is what is the responsibility sheet of product owner. Now three main responsibilities: own the product backlog, prioritize the work, accept or reject the work. You should have the guts to reject the work also, isn't it? It's not been always required that you should accept the work. Proxy product owner. Who is the proxy product owner? This is a role. Okay, so somebody from the Scrum core team comes in as the proxy product owner and is the middleman between the product owner and the team, but not the Scrum master. Up till now we have seen that the middleman is Scrum Master, right? So any important thing that is that can be cited from the left hand side is that the product owner can delegate some of the work of writing user stories to business analyst, right? I have mentioned the relationship between business analyst and the product owner. Some of the thing can be shouldered to the business analyst, right? So this is also one particular thing that one can do. This is what is the end of the session.